We have never seen really other than, well, I don't think we've ever seen anything like this from a president of the United States. And I think, as Jake said, it's sad and it is truly pathetic. And of course it is dangerous and of course it will go to courts, but you'll notice the president did not have any evidence presented at all, nothing. No real actual evidence of any kind of fraud. He talked about people putting up papers in windows. He talked about things that he'd seen on the internet. That is the president of the United States. That is the most powerful person in the world. And we see him like an obese turtle on his back, flailing in the hot sun, realizing his time is over. But he just hasn't accepted it, and he wants to take everybody down with him, including this country. Gloria?
You know, I think that the world is watching, and they're watching an American president undermine democracy in the United States. It's painful to those of us who love America. It is painful and dangerous, what he's doing. It is not surprising, of course, because he told us early on that if he didn't win, he was going to say the election was rigged, and maybe we didn't believe he would come out and do it in this way. But it is still startling to us to just hear the president from a podium in the White House undermine democracy. And as Jake was saying before, I have to keep saying, if this was such a big plot by Democrats, why didn't they do better? Why didn't they do better in the House? Why didn't they do better in the Senate? So the president makes himself the ultimate victim here. Over and over again, it's about him. It's not about the fact that the other Republicans did okay. It's about him, and his family is complaining. Why isn't everybody coming out and defending him? Why isn't Lindsey Graham coming out and defending him? Because a lot of Republicans, it is time for them to say enough is enough.
Rick Santorum?
No Republican elected official is going to stand behind that statement. I mean, none of them will. They will stand behind elements of that statement. They will stand behind his comment about the polling and how you could make the argument that it was suppression and dishonest. I mean, you can stand behind the lack of transparency when it came to allowing the votes to be counted. There's evidence of that, and he provided some evidence for that. There are certain things they will stand behind in that statement because they reflect the reality. But much of that statement was not factual and was at times incendiary and not something that President of the United States should say or any elected officials.
You said
unless you have evidence to prove it. And at this point in time, we don't, and we won't until there is an investigation as to what to happen. And for I got to tell you, I sat there and I listened to him talking about the votes being taken away from him. And then he shifted to Arizona and said, you know, hey, I win this thing if they count the votes. Well, how can you say, well, we have to wait and count the votes in Arizona and I can win this thing if we're making it. But if you count the votes in Philadelphia, you're stealing them. The reality is, in Pennsylvania, Democrats voted by mail and Republicans voted by in person. And it's because you asked them to do so. So I think most people, hopefully, I just encourage people to listen, because I know there's a lot of people who think this election is stolen. A lot of people think there is fraud. And you know what? There may be fraud. There may be all the, we don't know that right now. And for the president to go out there and claim that without any evidence of that is dangerous. And I just would say to the president, you know, there may be some validity in some of the things that you believe, but to go out there and suggest that this is rigged, or that counting votes in my home state by clerks all over 67 counties, and as you kept losing votes, was somehow rigged. No, Democrats voted by mail. That's why your lead went away. Had they voted in person, you would be in the same position we are right now. So it's very disappointing. Shocking at times to hear the president say the things that he said. And I'm hopeful that that Republicans will stand up at this moment and say what needs to be said about the integrity of our election. be tough, fight. I want him to fight. I want him to make sure that this election was held fairly, but I don't want him to make to draw these conclusions when he doesn't have the evidence to back it up.
Well, I just want to thank you for what you just said. First of all, it's not an easy thing to say, given the polarity in the country. But I just want to just say, as a dad, as an American, as a Democrat, as a human being, I appreciate you saying that. I hope that other Republicans will also stand with you. You're right. You've been all night. There are some things that you guys don't like, and you want to fight on those narrow issues. But to have the President of the United States take that position that he took, I think is very dangerous. But it's comforting to me that our system is holding. People are still counting these votes. We're still moving forward. And I just want to say I appreciate you saying that.
The governor of Georgia is going to count these votes. The governor of Arizona is going to count these votes. I mean, they're Republican governors.
Yeah. Secretary of State in Georgia, I believe.
Yeah, and the Secretary of State. So, look,
Other Republicans do? What does a Mitch McConnell come out and say?
Mitch McConnell's going to say what Mitch McConnell said today. We're going to count the votes. And that's what every Republican is going to say. The votes in Pennsylvania need to be counted. People voted. You have to count their votes. And if there are instances in which we find some sort of fraud or some sort of
shenanigans
that are being played, you investigate them, you get to the bottom of them, and if they're substantial, I mean, there's this claim running out there that there's 130,000 votes, and the president referred to it, that came out of nowhere in Michigan. Okay, if that's true, prove it. Right. Go out there and find where, you know, find it and do it. And if it's true, then you got a serious problem, and then we attack it. But counting absentee ballots and counting mail-in ballots is not fraud.
Especially
let's be clear. The president believes that an election is fraudulent when he does not win. That is what he believes. Before the election in 2016, when he thought he wasn't going to win, he predicted that the election would be rigged, that the election was fraudulent. When he didn't win the popular vote, he contended that the 3 million votes that he lost by were fraudulent votes, and he impaneled a commission, a government commission, to find those votes, and they never could. So really this is incredibly disturbing, but it's not surprising. This is who he is. I have big differences with Donald Trump over policy and, you know, the same differences that I probably have with you over some of these policies. But what we've learned is how much our democracy relies on people of goodwill in high places respecting its tenets, understanding that its institutions are absolutely essential and there to its functioning, and there is nothing more sacred than this institution, and he is willing to subjugate the institutions of our democracy to his own personal interests, and that has been true from the beginning. This is the latest and the saddest chapter, and it's increasingly looking like the last one.
I want to add something, Gloria, if you don't mind.
Go ahead.
Part of what he said that's so terrible is that he's attacking actual Americans who right now, he said in Detroit, they're not letting Republicans in. That's literally not true. It's just not true. Republicans and Democrats are standing shoulder to shoulder in Detroit right now counting those votes. So it's unbelievable the level of lying that he's doing. Putin could not come up with a better attack on our democracy.
I couldn't agree with you more.
The President of the United States.
Let me say something that let's just be really blunt about this. Why is he talking about Detroit? Why is he talking about Philadelphia? Yeah. It's not subtle. It's race. It's race. It's Donald Trump's go-to play. It's disgusting. So I just want to say that.
I appreciate you teeing it up. It's unbelievable that he can say these cities are known for corruption, et cetera, et cetera. There's corruption all across this country, in every institution. Why are you singling out these two black cities? Why are you denying the victory that these people have fought for? I'm upset about it because African Americans have fought so hard for the right to vote. I just want to finish. African Americans and our allies have fought so hard for the right. This right to vote for us is precious. John Lewis died this year. This is something we went and we got young African Americans across this country to believe, to buy in, to stand in line, to do this thing, and have the President of the United States crap all over their efforts. It hurts. And you can say he doesn't mean it to be racial, but it feels racial to us.
It's disgraceful. I've covered politics a really long time, and I've never witnessed anything like this. And again, as you were saying, you're not surprised, but it's still stunning and striking at so many levels. You talk about the issue of race. I totally agree with you. But it's watching a president who is unable to accept loss or potential loss, defeat. Losing is for suckers. Remember that? If he can't accept it, so he has to find a way to undermine the process that has him losing. And the process that has him losing is democracy. How can you do that when you are president of the United States? Again, not surprising, but just shocking and very sad.